Hello there. Now we will see the phenomena of superconductivity, its property and how it is work. Question is, why we need the superconductor? How we avail of these properties? Okay. Now, the superconductivity phenomena is devised by the Kamerling Ohms on 8th April 1911. The discovery of superconductivity is the greater discovery in the era of 90s. He discovered it while he studied the resistance of solid mercury at critical temperature. So superconductivity is considered as the phenomena of the zero electrical resistance when we cooled the substance between the temperature that called the critical temperature. When material exhibits the superconductivity, it becomes to expel the magnetic field. As you can see in the graph, that is the temperature versus resistance. When in the normal metal, when the temperature is decreased, then the resistance also decreases, and at the zero Kelvin, the resistance is also zero. But in superconductor, the certain point TC, it becomes zero resistance. Okay. So the theory behind the superconductivity is called the BCS theory, whose full form is Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer. This theory tells when the slightly one electron distort the lattice of atom in a superconductor, drawing toward it a small axis of positive charge, and then it attracts the second electron and become a pair, and which is called the Cooper pair or the BCS pair, as you can see in the diagram of the following slide. Yeah, that is the Cooper pair between the electron and the distance is around 100 nanometer. The property of this Cooper pair is different from the two individual electron. Okay, so this is in the BCS theory. The band gap is around 0.001 electron volt, which is very less. So at certain temperature, the material exhibit the superconductor. So this was devised in BCS theory. Okay, now we can see the phonon is the quasi particle, which is the quanta of periodic arrangement of atom in any crystal. In this diagram, there are the arrangement of atom, and these are the electrons which distort when it moves from one side to another side of crystal. Are the difference between the phonon and the photon, where the phonon is the quantized normal modes of the lateral vibration, while the photons are quantized normal mode of electromagnetic wave. And as the matter of energy, it is given by the hvs upon lambda, and for photon it given by hc upon lambda, and the momentum of both are given by the h upon lambda. Okay, now in the lower part there is the photon wavelength, which is the 10 to the power minus 6 meter, and the phonon wavelength, which is around 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So that these are the basic difference between phonon and photons. Now we can see the Meissner effect. So what is the Meissner effect? The Meissner effect is the effect of expulsion of magnetic line of force from a semiconductor material. You can see in the diagram, temperature greater than the critical temperature where the magnetic field penetrates the material, but in case of superconductor less than the critical temperature TC, it not penetrate the material. Okay, this is the example of Meissner effect, where the magnet are levitating above the superconductor, which is cooled by the liquid nitrogen. Okay, so this is the real phenomena of the Meissner effect, not the hypothesis form. Okay, now we can go to the application part of this. This is the MRI, means magnetic resonance imaging, where we use the high power of magnetic field. So for this reason we use the superconductivity phenomena. Here the required magnetic strength is around 0.5 to 2 tesla, which is very large amount of magnetic field, and which is only possible by the application of superconductor in MRI. Okay, so we use here, you can imagine this as the matter, that the strength of earth is only around 0.5 gauss, and in 1 tesla there is 10,000 gauss. Okay. The next application is the magnetron. Magnetron, there is two types of magnet are used. One to repel the train and one is to floating the train. It means it goes the train from one side to the another side. Okay, and this is the another real example of the superconductor, which made our life very easy and also save our time. Okay, so these are the application part of superconductor. Now there is also the limitation of the superconductor, is they are behave like superconductor below the critical temperature, means 0 Kelvin. So it is not a easy job for us to create the critical temperature. Okay, so this is the limitation of this, but there is the solution of this. Now scientists are researching about the problem of this and to create the superconductor at the higher temperature, and we got the success about this, and this is the achievement. In 2009, the scientist created the highest temperature superconductor around 110 degrees Celsius, and the material name is mercury, thallium, barium, calcium, copper oxide. Okay, so these are all about the superconductor, how it works, its working and its application in our daily life. So I hope you understand. Thank you.